Welcome to my creative time with Emma, and also welcome to another quick Friday tip of the day. For today's tip, I actually got from my mother. She had made this pretty card, and I asked her what color was the little lace she put on it. Actually, I'll show it to you right here. Isn't this pretty? She did such an awesome job. Right here, she used my little flower petal dies. She did lots of cuddle bugging, which I was very proud of her of. And she also used my little fancy frame and die set along with Mom You Rock stamp set. That's where she got the sentiments. The sentiment moms are the best flowers picked. And she totally outdid herself with her bows. Isn't this pretty? Super cute yellow. This is, I don't know, I think yellow's in right now because I've seen a lot of it and it's just totally inspiring me to use lots of yellow. So anyways, I wanted to show you this because I asked her, where did she get that color from? She said that she actually dyed it in tea, which, you know how I always see the tea dyed stuff? You always see that? Well, you actually really do can do it, I should say. So basically what she did, this was the original color of the lace. And what she did, all she did was just make some plain Lipton tea. And I'm assuming you can use any kind of tea. And I'm assuming like if you use like maybe a berry tea, it'll probably turn into a berry color. I'm not too sure. I haven't really experimented with it. But she used regular Lipton tea. And this is what she came out with. Now, depending on how dark you want it, she didn't leave this in for too long. So basically, she dipped it in the little tea after it was done. and then took it out and let it dry out like that. Now, this is a white color and this is the color she did. She actually left this one in for longer. So this is basically the results you will come out with. So if you kind of wanted like a little, you only had white lace, now you could have like a little vintagey, little different color lace. You could go ahead and dye using real tea. And I believe she used the Lipton tea. And now I'm curious because I know I have like a berry tea. I think it's like a raspberry tea. I can't remember exactly what it is, but I'm actually going to try it one day to see if it turns like a raspberry color, because I'm actually curious now. So anyways, that is my tip of the day for you. And I'm going to quickly show you again her super duper cute card. This is what she actually dyed her little, because this originally was white and I thought it came out very, very pretty. And then what I'm going to do, since Sunday is Nurses Day and my BFF from high school, she's a nurse, I wanted to make her a quick card. So what I did was I just used this little nurse's hat, and let me see, I got it from Paper Dolls for Every Day. Or Everyday Paper Dolls. I'm not, in the Gypsy it says Paper Dolls for Every Day. But anyways, what I did was I cut the nurse's hat out at 3 3/4 inches. And then I copied it over and did use the hide contour. And I just made a plain red one. So this way that could go on the back. But in between is where, can you see it right there? Is where I used some pop dots and I also glued my lace in there. And then I used some stickles. And then I used to go ahead and just ink up the edges. I used the frayed burlap. And then if you could see closely, I actually used my brand new distress marker, the frayed burlap. Isn't that cool? I'm so excited about these markers. I haven't really gotten a chance to really play with them yet, but I plan to. So anyways, everybody, I will turn this into a card and you will see it at the end of my video. And just so you'll know, somebody asked me if I had anything for Nurses Day, and I do. It is the More Gift Card Sentiments, and this is it right there. Happy Nurses Day. So you will see the completed card at the end of this video. If it's not there, go ahead and look for it on my blog at www.creativetimeforme.com. Have a fabulous, fabulous weekend, everybody. And don't forget to tune in on Monday because there is going to be a Peachy King alumni blog hop. So I'm so super excited to hop along with my fabulous, talented Peachy sisters. We used to all be on the same team together. So we are going to have a fun blog hop for you called That's What Friends Are For, and that will be on Monday. So don't forget to tune in for that. I'm actually going to be having two posts on Monday, one for Imagine Monday and one for the Peachy Keen blog hop. So you never know, I may just have two videos that day. Have a fabulous day, everybody, and fabulous weekend, and I will see you back here next week. Bye-bye.